Consider this particular example. Sort above elements using quadratic sort. Now how to solve this particular example? In quadratic sort, we always sort the elements in the first phase according to the unit plus digit. So if you see, all the numbers given to us are in the three-digit form. Three digits are there in every number, right? So the first digit place, that is 101, if you see here, this one is at unit place, 0 is at 10th place, and next one is at 100th place. Similarly, every digit at unit place, 10th place, and 100th place, right? So how this quadratic sort going to sort these elements? In quadratic sort, in pass 1, it sort the elements according to unit place. So I'm going to write the solution here for this problem. In pass 1, it sorts the elements according to unit place. So we have say the Q of 0, which consists of all the elements which we're going to store all the numbers given to us which has 0 at unit place. Then we will prepare all the queues for all the digits, that is Q0, Q1, Q2. Then we have Q3. Then we have Q4. Likewise, till Q of 9, we will prepare this first. We will prepare this first. Q of 6. Q of 7, then Q of 8, then Q of 9. Once this is ready, we will scan the list from left to right. We will scan all the elements from left to right. We pick the first element and we'll check what is the unit place digit. So here in first pass, it sorts the elements according to unit place digits. Okay, you have to look at the number and check what is the unit place for the digit. It is 1. For this number, unit place is 1. Here I am writing in the queue of 1, we will place 101, because if you check the unit place of the number 101, the unit place is 1. So we will put all the numbers whose unit place is 1 in the queue of 1 array. Okay. Now take the next element, that is 100. The unit place of 100 is 0. So I must place this 100 here in a queue of 0. Then we have triple line 999. The unit place for this triple line is 9. So it goes into this sub array, that is triple line. Then 888 will go into the array of this Q of 8. 777 will go into this array, that is 777. Then we have 555. Unit place digit is 5, that's why it goes into this place 555. Next we have 666. So the unit plus digit is 6, so it will go into this queue, that is 666 here. Then 444 will go into the queue of 4, because unit plus digit is 4. Then 333 will go into this queue. Then 111 will go in the queue of 1, because unit place is 1. So it will be placed after 101 in this queue. Then we have 112. And the unit place for 112 is 2. So it goes into Q of 2, is 112. Then the last number is 343. So it goes into Q of 3, because the unit place for 343 is 3. So this is the output of the first pass. If I now write the output of the first pass, is now you have to collect all the elements from Q0 to Q9 sequentially. So it is 100 first, then 101, then 111, then 112. Then we have 333, then 343, then 444, then 555, then 666, then 777, then 888, then 999. So now we arrange all the elements of pass 1 from Q0 to Q9. So definitely, if you check the original element list given to us, and now the elements are now rearranged after pass 1 according to the unit place. So some sorting has happened to pass 1, but this is not the end of this sorting. So it, for further step, it will going to sort the elements according to tens place digit. Then the next pass, if it goes, then it going to sort the elements according to 100 place. If there are 4 digit number, then it goes to pass number 4, and there it sorts the elements according to 4th place, that is 1000 place digit. Right. So let us continue this particular example, and I will give pass number 1 as an input to pass number 2, output of pass 1 to pass number 2 as the input. Here in pass 2, it sorts the elements of pass 1 output according to tens place digits. So again, I will take this as a reference, and we will again modify these cues, right? So I'll remove this here from here for second pass. Again, there are 9 cues from 0 to 9, 10 cues, right? And then we'll start putting the values into these cues. Let's start the pass 2, where we have the input as these elements, right? So our job is to put this element in pass 2 in the appropriate queue. Take the first element of this, that is 100, where it should go. You have to look for 10 space digit, that is the second digit in this number, that is 0. So it goes into this subarray, queue of 0. Then again, 101 is the next number. You have to check for second digit, that is 10th place digit, that is 0 again. It goes into this queue of 0 after 100. Then the third number is 111, that is 101. This unit 10th place digit is 1, so it goes into queue of array of 1. Similarly, 1912 is the number, its 10th place digit is 1, that's why it is also placed into this queue of 1. Next number is 333. It goes into queue of 3 because the tens place digit of this number is 3. Then we have 343. Its tens place digit is 4, so it goes into the queue of 4 array. 343. Then the next number is 444. Its tens place digit is 4. It goes into the same queue, the queue of 4. The next number is 555, its 10th place digit is 5, that's why it goes into this queue. Then we have 666, its 10th place digit is 6, it goes into this queue. 777 goes into the next queue, that is queue of 7, because 10th place digit for 777 is 7. For 888 it is Q8. Similarly, for the last number, 999 goes into last queue. So this is the arrangement for pass 2, and definitely it is different than pass 1. You can check pass 1 arrangement and pass 2 arrangements for the elements. So we successfully placed all the elements into the respective queue in pass 2. Now we have to find the output for pass 2. Output of pass 2 of second pass is, again, get the output of second pass. We have to pick all the elements from Q0 to Q9. So the first element in Q0 is 100, next element is 101, next element in Q1 is 111, 112, then 333, then 343, then we have 444, then 555, 666, then 777, 888, and last number is 999. So this is the output of our second pass. So you can check the output of the first pass, and similarly the output of the second pass, definitely there is some difference and the elements are sorted according to second digits. Let us move to the pass number 3 now. For pass number 3, because every number given to us has 3 digits, we have to perform 3 passes. So in the last pass, that is in pass number 3, we sort all the elements of this output of second pass according to 100 plus digit. It sorts in the elements of second pass according to the hundreds place. Digit. Again, we will refer this queues Q0 to Q9. First of all, we'll make it empty and then we'll start putting the values into this queue. We deleted all the elements. Now we'll start putting the values of second pass by considering it as input, and we put it into pass 3. In pass 3, we put these elements according to the third place digit value. So here, if you see, the first element in the second pass is 100 and the 100 plus digit is 1, so it must go into the queue of 100, comma. Next is 101, which 100 plus digit is 1, it also goes into the same queue. Then 111, its 100 plus is also 1, so it goes into the same queue. Then you can say 112, its 100 plus is 1, it goes into the same queue. Now check for the next number, that is 333, its 100 plus is 3, that's why it goes into the queue of 3. Next number also goes into queue of 3 because its 100 plus digit is 3. 343 is 100 plus digit is 3, so it also goes into queue of 3. Next number is 444, it goes into queue of 4. Because this 100 plus digit is 4. 555 will go into this queue of 5, and all the rest elements will be placed according to the 100 plus digit. So 666 will go into queue of 6, 777 will go into queue of 7, 888 will go into queue of 8, and 999 will go into queue of 9. Now if you find the output of this particular pass, then you will get the final sorted elements. So again, we'll go from Q0 to Q9 to pick the elements and arrange it in the sequence. So here 100 is the first element, then 101, and then 112. I'll put it here, all the elements of Q0, then all the, Q0, Q1, and then Q2 and Q3, and so on likewise. So next elements are these two, that is 333 and 343. Next we have 444, next 555, then 666, 777, 888, 999. So now if you check the output of the pass number 3, you can see all the elements are now sorted. Check all the elements, they are in a ascending order, they are sorted. So this way we can sort the elements using radix sort. So let me know, are there any questions from your